Hello students, welcome to my online lecture session of subject COA. Today we will discuss methods of asynchronous data transfer, which is a part of unit 5 input output organization. Objective: in this video lecture, first of all we discuss methods of asynchronous data transfer. Then there are two types of method. First one is strop control and second is handshaking method. Now start our session with first method, strop control. In asynchronous data transfer, there is a no clock on both sides, sender and receiver, so that first of all a signal is passed from source to destination to inform about the data transfer. Now in a strop control method, there are two types. First is source initiated strop for data transfer, that means strop signal is initiated by the source unit. Now here in this diagram, here source unit is there and here destination unit. First of all, whenever source unit wants to transfer the data to the destination, then it places the data on the data bus. After placing the data, it generates a strop signal to inform the destination unit that I am sending the data on the data bus. So the timing diagram for these two signals is like that. First of all, data is put on the data bus. So first signal is data, and it is active. It is it is a valid data between these two lines. Now, after placing the data on the data bus, source unit generate the strop signal. So here the strop signal is start like this, and it is active till the data is on the data bus. Now second types is destination initiated strop for data transfer, that means strop signal is initiated by the destination unit. Now in the block diagram of this category is like this. First of all, strop signal is initiated by the destination unit to inform the source that now I am ready to receive the data, so please place the data on the data first. After receiving the strop signal from the destination unit, source unit place the data on the data bus. So here in this diagram, timing diagram, we can see that first of all strop signal is activated, after that data signal is activated, and both signal is activated till the valid data is transferred from the source to destination. Now there are two disadvantages of this strop control method. First is for the source initiated data transfer, that means source unit that indicates the transfer has no way of knowing whether the destination unit has actually received the data which is placed by the source unit. And second is destination unit that indicates the transfer means the strop signal is initiated by the destination unit, but it has no way of knowing whether the source unit actually placed the data on the data bus or not. Now to overcome these two disadvantages, one new method is activated, which is a handshaking. So second method is handshaking for asynchronous data transfer. Now in handshake method, one extra signal is required which inform the unit about the data transfer. This is a additional acknowledgement. Again here in handshaking method, there are two types of data transfer. First is source initiated data transfer, that means source is first inform the destination unit about the data. So in this block diagram of source initiated data transfer, First source unit place the data on the data bus. Place the valid data on the data bus. After placing the data, it informs the destination unit by extra signal, which is a data valid. Now there is a data on the data bus until this data valid signal is activated. After sending all the data, these both the signals are deactivated. Now whenever this data reach at the destination point, the destination unit sends an extra signal, which is a acknowledgement. It's known as data accepted signal to the source unit. So here the source unit has acknowledged that the destination unit received the data which is sent by it. So the diagram, timing diagram for this three signal is like that. First of all, the data source unit place the data on the data bus, so that here data bus is first activated. After placing the data, source unit send data valid signal to the destination. So here this data valid signal is activated. After data valid signal, data is reached at the destination unit, so that destination unit initiate activate the data accepted signal. So here data accepted signal is that. Now after completion of data means now all the data are reached at the destination unit. Now there is no data on the data bus, so that data bus and data valid both signals are deactivated. After deactivating these both signals by the source unit, destination unit again deactivate the data accepted signal. Now second types is destination initiated data transfer using handshaking. So here data transfer is initiated by the destination unit. Now in this block diagram, first of all destination unit inform the source unit that I am ready for receive the data. So destination unit sends one signal ready for data to the source unit. After receiving this signal, source unit place the valid data on the data bus and also active the data valid signal, so that due to data valid signal, destination unit informs that now data is valid on the data bus. Now both signals are valid active till the data is on the data bus. Now timing diagram, here first signal is ready for data, so it is activated first. After receiving the ready for data signal, source unit first place the data on the data bus. So here second signal is activated by the data bus. So here data bus is activated. After placing the data, source unit active the third signal, which is a data valid. Source unit active the data valid signal. Now data bus and data valid signal is active till the valid data is on the data bus. After that, ready for data signal is deactivated, so that then after data bus and data valid is also deactivated. Now advantage of this handshaking method is it provides a high degree of flexibility and reliability, because it both unit knows that there is a successful completion of a data transfer. If one of the unit for that means either source unit or destination is faulty, then data transfer will not be completed, and it is informed by the due to the signal. Error can be detected by means of a timeout mechanism. I hope you enjoy this video lecture session. Thank you.